G'day mate, welcome to Australia.
Yeah, I'm on my way to the rocks. Can you
rocks? Yeah, the rocks,
tell me a little bit about it?
The rocks is that way and it's just got a lot of rocks.
Yeah, big rocks, small rocks.
Yeah.
You might be able to see some people up there right now actually.
Oh yeah, you can see them. Let's go take a look. The people are like right there.
I'm walking on the Harbour Bridge.
Well, stay laying down on the floor. I want to know if you beat the shoulder that I need. I want to go. So take me to Neverland.
Good morning, it's June 20th, my birthday, yeah! Here in Australia, Sydney. It's my second day, and technically my birthday started earlier because Australia is 15 hours in advance in LA. So it's not my birthday yet in LA, but it is over here. And right now I'm on Dixon Street, which is Australia's Chinatown.
Oh, thank you. Nice table. This is my view from the restaurant, and across the way is Market City. I'll take the char siu bao.
Yeah.
Steamed char siu bao. Ooh. Got the char siu bao and the cooked bowl tea. This is a steamed char siu bao. Check out the filling. Hot, huh? Okay. Just the feng jiao. Feng jiao, that's chicken feet right there.
Chicken feet.
有排骨？排骨。有排骨？排骨。唔該曬。唔該曬。The aftermath of my dim sum.
Man, I am pretty stuffed. It's pretty difficult to eat dim sum by yourself. Like, I ordered 3 dishes and it's just so much food when it's just one person.
Hope come psych off.
Oh,
okay. This is called the Emperor's Puff. Now I'm gonna try the famous Emperor's Puff. Nice and hot. Wow. How's it so good. They have goat hot pot. The Emperor's Garden restaurant has been established since 1979 for 40 years. Yum cha place. Alright, thank you so much.
Alright,
bye bye. That place right there was a success. Had some delicious dim sum, and I was also able to try the famous cream puffs behind me right here. They have a separate bakery department right here. Covent Garden, like in London.
Up for 32 hours, no sleeping yet. And I gotta get out of this basement. Walls closing, tight falling, I'm drowning. I feel lost, full of sorrow, I'm dying. To get back out, to get back out in front of you.
The bird lady there.
About to hop on the metro to Circular Quay. Eddy Avenue Food Coffee Express. And there's Central Station. It's 2 p.m. and I'm right in front of the Sydney Opera House. I just purchased a ticket to go see a show tonight, a concert, and it starts at 6:30, and you can go early and have a nice view of the harbor. So I may enter a bit early. Right now, the plan is to check out the botanical gardens, but I really need an iced coffee, so I'm gonna find myself an iced coffee, and then we'll spin to the botanical gardens. Whoa.
How's it going?
Wait, what's your name?
Mark Sorrell.
And where are you from?
Sydney.
Sydney? You were born and raised here?
Yep, born and raised here, 21 years old.
Wow.
Doing the personal training out here.
Hey, personal training?
That's
right. That must be very big here. Because
One of the biggest cities actually, yeah, for that. Highest pay rates actually.
Wow.
Pretty good.
Okay, you live in a beautiful city.
It is actually, yeah. You know, the weather's sometimes can be a bit bipolar, but definitely in regards to what you get, it's a good environment.
Uh-huh. Well, I mean, I'm from Los Angeles, and the winter time feels similar to the winter here, so it may be a similar climate to my city.
All right, that's good to know. It's pretty interesting.
Yeah, and we're here at this is the Circular Quay, right?
That's right, it's the Circular Quay.
You can see the Harbour Bridge. So have you ever climbed the Harbour Bridge?
Nah, not personally, no.
But you can walk across it just fine.
You can, that's right. Just along the actual roadway there.
Uh-huh.
There's a train that goes through it.
Uh-huh.
But yeah, you can also climb right across the top of the bridge there.
Yeah.
You might be able to see some people up there right now, actually.
Oh, yeah. You can see them. Let's go take a look. Wow. Yeah, you can see the people.
That's right.
The people are like right there. Right there. Am I pointing at the right spot? Look. Right there, huh? Wow, they look like ants. Dang, look at this beautiful harbor. Look at that beautiful image right there. Well, I'm gonna go get an iced coffee, so what do you recommend?
Just right here. I wouldn't be too familiar with the actual name, to be honest. Lots of bacteria around, but definitely icy.
Hey, what do you know about this restaurant right here?
Not much.
Not much?
No.
Come back to this place for some beef pies. Back out, to get back out in front of you. To get back. Hey, which way to the Royal Botanical Gardens?
This is just the Royal Botanical Gardens. You go through that gate right in front of us.
Uh-huh.
And you're there.
Oh, thank you. How about Mrs. McQuarrie's lookout point?
If you do Google Maps, it'll come up.
Oh,
and
okay.
There's signs everywhere. Just go in. Go right when you go through the gate, and the signs to everywhere.
But the lookout point, I'm guessing, if it's on like a corner, it'd be just like over there.
Yeah. Oh, is there
Do you want to look over the harbour with like the opera house and stuff?
Yeah, that sounds good.
Yeah, just go straight
just
and
right
make,
and then left.
Yep.
Okay, right and left.
Right and left. You can see the ocean.
Okay. Thanks so much.
Okay.
Hey, are you guys from here?
Yeah.
Yeah. No.
Because I haven't seen any Aussies say to me. Good eye, mate.
Yeah. Only in the country, you gotta go to like Wagga Wagga.
Oh.
Go to rural area for that. We gotta go to that.
Alright, thank you so much.
One,
bye. The Royal Botanical Garden. Did you get a drink from Harry's too?
Sorry?
Did you get a drink from Harry's too?
No. In the rock seawood.
This Dracaena dracul fell over in May 2008. The tree will not be lifted back to its former upright position as the trunk is damaged near the base and further movement may cause it to snap off. The tree has been fenced off to help protect the branches from damage and to reduce soil compaction around the roots. Dracaena dracul is native to the Canary Islands and can live for up to 600 years in the wild. This tree is over 100 years old. The common name of dragon's blood tree comes from the bright red resin the tree produces. One of the many uses for the resin was the production of a varnish used by violin makers. Beautiful tree. So right now, it's about 3 p.m., a little bit after, and I'm walking to Mrs. McQuarrie's viewpoint. Is that correct?
Yeah.
I met these two gals here, and they were so nice and helped me take some photos.
And introduce yourselves.
I'm Isabel.
I'm Sanjana.
Yeah, and you guys are locals in Sydney? Yeah.
Yep.
Dang, tell me about your city. Like, what's the best things to do around here? We're probably doing one of the best activities right now, just hanging out in the Royal Botanical Gardens, is that right?
Yeah. I mean, there's so much to see here, and like, I think one of the best parts is like definitely like the gardens and like the harbor.
Yeah,
gotta get the beaches too.
Okay. And the beaches,
okay, yeah, that one, the beaches I haven't seen yet. So which beach do you recommend if I had to choose?
Well, I mean, you have to go to Bondi.
Bondi.
Yeah,
okay.
You gotta go to Bondi.
Okay, so I'm gonna go to Bondi Beach tomorrow.
Yes, yeah, do it.
And then, do you recommend taking the ferry to Manly?
Yes, that's another thing, yeah.
We definitely have to take that from here.
Yeah.
Yeah, so those are two activities that I plan on doing tomorrow. Do you think I can fit them both in?
Yeah,
it's gonna be a big day. Yeah.
Okay. Cool.
Get up early.
Okay, I will.
It's a lot of transit time.
But it's very pretty. What you'll see will be worth it.
And what do you recommend that I do in Bondi?
Do the walk to Coogee.
Yeah.
No, long, but that's good. Probably not gonna be enough time, right?
If it's only like 2.5 hours.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So how would you plan my itinerary if I wanted to go to Manly as well?
I don't even know.
That's I reckon you start off by going to Manly in the morning. And then like you just go to the beach. Chill at the beach. Maybe stay there until lunch. And then like come back and then go to Bondi.
Okay.
Do like the beaches kind of.
That sounds really nice.
Like a beach kind of day.
Okay. Yeah. I think I might give that a go.
Yeah,
so
yeah, well, this is the point. Also.
Have we reached the spot?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Right here, you see them like adjacent to each other instead of like stacked.
Yeah. That is very pretty. You have that boat with you, by the way.
Yeah, that's true. And what's this rock area right here?
Yeah, I think it's just a bunch of rocks. Because it looks like a photo destination. I mean, I don't blame them. It's kind of cool.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
But I didn't think it had any.
Oh, look, and you can see the two Australian flags right there.
Oh yes,
and then the climbers too.
Yeah. Oh, you know what? You should definitely climb.
G'day, mate. Welcome to Australia.
I just met a couple of very nice girls, and it's so nice hanging out with people that you meet and locals, and just part of the best part about traveling. Yeah, I'm on my way to the rocks. Can you
rocks? Yeah, the rocks.
Tell me a little bit about it.
The rocks is that way, and it's just got a lot of rocks and a lot of restaurants.
Oh, really?
Yeah, big rocks, small rocks.
What is this thing? Is that a microphone?
Yeah, it is. So that's
sick. It's good that you're going off a book.
No, I want this one. No, I already walked right here. Oh, so I just need to get back to here and walk around like that. Okay. Okay, that's cool.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
A few moments later.
I'm walking on the Harbour Bridge.
Up for 32 hours, no sleeping yet. And I gotta get out of this basement. Walls closing, tight falling, I'm drowning. I feel lost, full of sorrow, I'm dying. To get back out, to get back out in front of you. To get back out in front of you. But I'm drowning, I'm drowning, I'm drowning. What's the point of getting out if everything I touch it goes a different route?
Wow, what an amazing day. And I'm about to go into the opera house right now and catch a concert. So thank you for watching, and I encourage everybody to go travel and explore the world and just do it, you know, just be brave and don't be afraid, and go out and just see the world. It's like, it's almost like a very surreal feeling. It's just like the best feeling that you can get. Like this, you get this surge of energy and you just feel alive, like just feel like rejuvenated. So thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel and I will catch you on the next one.